Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Filipino ebook before it's gone.
In this video, you'll learn 20 of the most common words and phrases in Filipino. Hi everybody, my name is Sei. Welcome to the 800 Core Filipino Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Filipino. But there's a twist. With each new lesson in this series, we'll include the previous lessons at the end. So after you've learned the new words and phrases, stick around and review what you've learned in the previous lessons. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get the full list right now at filipinopod101.com. Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard deck, and finally, master Filipino. Okay, let's get started. First is kawali, frying pan, kawali, kawali, frying pan. Ang mga sibuyas ay ginigisa sa kawali. The onions are being sauteed in the frying pan. Ang mga sibuyas ay ginigisa sa kawali. Sangkalan. Cutting board. Sangkalan. Sangkalan. Cutting board. Ang tagaluto ay naghihiwa ng nilagang itlog sa sangkalan. The cook is cutting a hard-boiled egg on the cutting board. Ang tagaluto ay naghihiwa ng nilagang itlog sa sangkalan. Lababo. Sink. Lababo. Lababo. Sink. Ang lababo ay halos puno na. The sink is almost full. Ang lababo ay halos puno na. Mangkok. Bowl. Mangkok. Mangkok. Bowl. Ang mangkok ay walang laman. The bowl is empty. Ang mangkok ay walang laman. Labasan. Exit. Labasan. Labasan. Exit. Saan ang labasan? Where is the exit? Saan ang labasan? Mapa. Map. Mapa. Mapa. Map. Suriin ang mapa upang hanapin ang iyong destinasyon. Check the map to find your way to your destination. Suriin ang mapa upang hanapin ang iyong destinasyon. Maleta. Suitcase. Maleta. Maleta. Suitcase. Mura ang synthetic na maleta. The synthetic suitcase is cheap. Mura ang synthetic na maleta. Turista. Tourist. Turista. Turista. Tourist. Napakaraming turista ang bumubisita sa sentral na isla ng Pilipinas. There are a lot of tourists visiting the central islands of the Philippines. Napakaraming turista ang bumibisita sa sentral na isla ng Pilipinas. Politika. Politics. Politika. Politika. Politics. Ang sibahan ay hindi dapat sumasali sa politika. The church must not get involved in politics. Ang simbahan ay hindi dapat sumasali sa politika. Biolohiya. Biology. Biolohiya. Biolohiya. Biology. Ang biolohiya ay ang pag-aaral ng mga buhay na organismo. Biology is the study of living organisms. Ang biolohiya ay ang pag-aaral ng mga buhay na organismo. Kimika. Chemistry. Kimika. Kimika. Chemistry. Ako ay nagtapos ng antas sa kimika. I have a graduate degree in chemistry. Ako ay nagtapos ng antas sa kimika. Pisika. Physics. Pisika. Pisika. Physics. Alam ko ang mga pangunahing kaalaman ng pisika. I know the basics of physics. Alam ko ang mga pangunahing kaalaman ng pisika. Ekonomika. Economics. Ekonomika. Ekonomika. Economics. Magagamit ang pagkakaroon ng kaalaman sa ekonomika sa maraming larangan. Economics is a good background for many fields. Magagamit ang pagkakaroon ng kaalaman sa ekonomika sa maraming larangan. Ilagay. Put. Ilagay. Ilagay. Put. Pwede mo bang ilagay ang mga libro sa mesa? Can you put the books on the table? Pwede mo bang ilagay ang mga libro sa mesa? Alalahanin. Remember. Alalahanin. Alalahanin. Remember. Subukan mong alalahanin kung nasaan ka noong linggo ng gabi. Try to remember where you were last Sunday night. Subukan mong alalahanin kung nasaan ka noong linggo ng gabi. Hawakan. Hold. Hawakan. Hawakan. Hold. Hawakan mo ko sa braso nang hindi ka mawalan ng balanse pag andar ng tren. Hold my arm so you don't get off balance when the train starts moving. Hawakan mo ko sa braso nang hindi ka mawalan ng balanse pag andar ng tren. Cart. Shopping cart. 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 Shopping cart. Ang cart ng pinamili ay walang laman. The shopping cart is empty. Ang cart ng pinamili ay walang laman. Plastic bag. Plastic bag. Plastic bag. Plastic bag. Plastic bag. Ang lalaki ay may dalang plastic bag na puno ng mga pinamili. The man is carrying a plastic bag full of groceries. Ang lalaki ay may dalang plastic bag na puno ng mga pinamili. Komedya. Comedy. Komedya. Komedya. Comedy. Sila ay nanonood ng isang komedya at tumatawa. They're watching a comedy and laughing. Sila ay nanonood ng isang komedya at tumatawa. Nobela. Novel. Nobela. Nobela. Novel. sinulat ko ang aking unang nobela. I wrote my first novel. Sinulat ko ang aking unang nobela. Well done! In this lesson, you expanded your vocabulary and learned 20 new useful words. Click the link in the description and sign up for free at filipinopod101.com to get access to the full list of vocabulary you need for your daily life conversations. You'll also get example sentences, Question Plus card decks, and more learning resources. See you next time! Paalam!
Hi everyone, I'm Gabriella. How are your Filipino listening skills? In this video, you'll have a chance to test them out with a quiz. First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
May isang babae na nagtatanong sa salesman sa isang tindahan ng libro. Anong libro ang gustong makita ng babae? Mawalang galang lang. Gusto ko sanang makita yung libro sa istanteng iyon.
Anong librong gusto mo?
Yung tungkol sa mga kotse.
Sandali lang. Eto ba?
Oo, iyan nga.
Eto na.
Anong libro ang gustong makita ng babae? May isang babae na nagtatanong sa salesman sa isang tindahan ng libro. Anong libro ang gustong makita ng babae? Mawalang galang lang. Gusto ko sanang makita yung libro sa istanteng iyon.
Anong librong gusto mo?
Yung tungkol sa mga kotse.
Sandali lang. Eto ba?
Oo, iyan nga.
Eto na.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time! How are your Filipino listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
May isang babae at isang lalaki na tumitingin sa menu sa isang kainan. Ano ang o-orderin ng lalaki?
Ano ang o-orderin mo?
Mukhang masarap ang pizza. Sa palagay ko, yun ang o-orderin ko.
Nagpizza ako kahapon. Kaya...
Okay. Ano kaya kung hamburger?
Mukhang masarap. Sige, yun ang o-orderin ko.
Ano ang o-orderin ng lalaki? May isang babae at isang lalaki na tumitingin sa menu sa isang kainan. Ano ang o-orderin ng lalaki?
Ano ang o-orderin mo?
Mukhang masarap ang pizza. Sa palagay ko, yun ang o-orderin ko.
Nagpizza ako kahapon. Kaya...
Okay. Ano kaya kung hamburger?
Mukhang masarap. Sige, yun ang o-orderin ko.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Filipino listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
May isang lalaki na tumatawag sa opisina ng isang doktor. Anong oras niya kailangan na nasa opisina ng doktor? Hello, anong kailangan niyo?
Anong oras kayo magsasara ngayon?
Nagsasara kami ng alas 6. Pero pumunta na kayo bago mag-alas 5:30.
Okay, salamat.
Anong oras niya kailangan na nasa opisina ng doktor? May isang lalaki na tumatawag sa opisina ng isang doktor. Anong oras niya kailangan na nasa opisina ng doktor? Hello, anong kailangan niyo?
Anong oras kayo magsasara ngayon?
Nagsasara kami ng 6:00. Pero pumunta na kayo bago mag 5:30.
Okay, salamat.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time! How are your Filipino listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
May isang batang lalaki na nagbabasa ng kanyang talaarawan. Ano ang unang bagay na ginawa ng batang lalaki ngayong araw na ito?
Maganda ang panahon. Nag-swimming ako sa pool noong hapon. Tapos, nagpunta ako sa sinehan noong kinagabihan. Nag-aral din ako ng buong umaga. Hindi na masama.
Ano ang unang bagay na ginawa ng batang lalaki ngayong araw na ito? May isang batang lalaki na nagbabasa ng kanyang talaarawan. Ano ang unang bagay na ginawa ng batang lalaki ngayong araw na ito?
Maganda ang panahon. Nag-swimming ako sa pool noong hapon. Tapos, nagpunta ako sa sinehan noong kinagabihan. Nag-aral din ako ng buong umaga. Hindi na masama.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time! How are your Filipino listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
May isang lalaki at isang babae na tumitingin sa isang larawan. Anong larawan ang tinitignan nila? Ito yung larawan ng soccer team kung saan miyembro ang anak mo, hindi ba? Sino dito ang anak mo?
Ito.
Ah, siya ang pinakamatangkad.
Oo, mas matangkad pa siya kaysa sa akin.
Anong larawan ang tinitignan nila? May isang lalaki at isang babae na tumitingin sa isang larawan. Anong larawan ang tinitignan nila? Ito yung larawan ng soccer team kung saan miyembro ang anak mo, hindi ba? Sino dito ang anak mo?
Ito.
Ah, siya ang pinakamatangkad.
Oo, mas matangkad pa siya kaysa sa akin.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time!
Welcome to FilipinoPod101.com's Filipino sa 3 minuto. The fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Filipino. Kamusta? Ako si Erica. Kinagagalak kong makilala ka. Hi, I'm Erica. Nice to meet you. In this series, we're going to learn basic Filipino expressions. It's super easy and it only takes 3 minutes. In this lesson, you're going to learn how to introduce yourself in Filipino. Are you ready? Here we go. Kamusta? Ako si Erica. Kinagagalak kong makilala ka. Hi, I'm Erica. It's nice to meet you. Kamusta? Ako si Erica. Kinagagalak kong makilala ka. Did you get it? Let's take it step by step. Start by saying, Kamusta? This means, how are you? But it's commonly used to say, hi, in Filipino. Next, say, ako si, I am, and then your name. My name is Erica, so I'll say, ako si Erica. Finally, say, kinagagalak kong makilala ka. This means, it's nice to meet you.
Kinagagalak kong makilala ka.
Kamusta? Ako si Erica. Kinagagalak kong makilala ka.
Next, we're going to learn how to introduce ourselves in formal Filipino. But first, I'll teach you two words that turns any Filipino sentence formal. They are po and opo. Po, opo. All Filipinos learn these two words when they are young because they are a must when speaking politely to those who are older. Now here's how to introduce yourself in formal Filipino.
Kamusta po? Ako si Erica Reyes. Kinagagalak ko po kayong makilala.
How are you? I'm Erica Reyes. It's nice to meet you.
Kamusta po? Ako si Erica Reyes. Kinagagalak ko po kayong makilala.
Did you notice the word po in this introduction? Let's compare it with the informal introduction we learned earlier. First, we have kamusta po instead of just kamusta. As we've said before, kamusta means how are you and has essentially the same use as hi in English. It comes from the Spanish phrase como esta. We add the word po to this to make it polite. For the next sentence, there is no need to change ako si or I am. However, saying your full name is considered more formal. In the Philippines, we say our first names first and last names last. Finally, pay attention to the ending. We went from kinagagalak kong makilala ka to kinagagalak ko po kayong makilala. Ka or you is changed to the plural pronoun kayo to make the sentence more formal. The pronoun is moved to the front of the verb, and ng is added to connect the words. Finally, we also add po to the sentence to show respect. One more time. The informal way to introduce yourself in Filipino is kamusta? Ako si Erica. Kinagagalak kong makilala ka. The formal way to introduce yourself is kamusta po? Ako si Erica Reyes. Kinagagalak ko po kayong makilala. Now it's time for Erica's tips. Have you gotten hold of saying, kinagagalak kong makilala ka? Well, you might be surprised that Filipinos say, nice to meet you, more often than its Filipino counterpart. This is because many English words and phrases are used in daily conversation since English is the second official language of the Philippines. Filipinos also shake hands during first meetings, just like in many Western cultures. But of course, if you use the proper Filipino introduction, your new Filipino friends will definitely be impressed. Do you know how to say thank you in Filipino? How about you're welcome? Watch the next Filipino sa Tatlong Minuto lesson to find out. See you next time! Hanggang sa muli! Kamusta kayo? Ako si Erica. Hi everybody, I'm Erica. Welcome to FilipinoPod101.com's Filipino sa Tatlong Minuto, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Filipino. In the last lesson, we learned how to introduce ourselves in Filipino. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to use good manners as we thank people. Handa na ba kayo? Are you ready? Then let's go! Here's how we say thank you in Filipino. It's very easy. Salamat.
Salamat.
Salamat means thank you. When saying thank you very much, you just need to add maraming. Maraming salamat.
Maraming salamat.
Marami means a lot, and the ng is a connector added to marami to connect marami and salamat. Maraming salamat literally means many thanks and is equivalent to thank you very much. During the last lesson, we mentioned the informal and formal way of speaking Filipino. Salamat is the informal way to thank someone. When thanking someone older than you,
you need to use the polite formal form. Do you remember what we need in order to do that? That's right. We just need to add the word po. Salamat po. Salamat po. If you really want to thank someone in a formal setting, you can add maraming, which means a lot, as we have just learned. Maraming salamat po. Maraming salamat po. Now, how do you answer? It's easy. Just say, walang anuman. Walang anuman. Walang anuman literally means it's nothing, but it is the equivalent of you are welcome. Wala means nothing, while anuman stands for whatsoever. It is a very common phrase to say when replying to a friend or a stranger who is thanking you. To make it formal and more polite, just add po. Walang anuman po. Walang anuman po. So when someone says salamat or maraming salamat po to you, you can simply reply with walang anuman or walang anuman po. Yes, it's that easy. Now it's time for Erica's tips. The word salamat is said to have been of Semitic origin. It sounds similar to the Arabic salam and the Hebrew shalom, meaning peace. Filipino has been influenced by many languages throughout history, so don't be surprised if you find similar sounding words from other languages, most especially Spanish words. Do you know that Filipinos have a specific greeting during the noontime? In our next Filipino sa Tatlong Minuto lesson, you'll learn this and other greetings in Filipino. See you next time! Hanggang sa muli! Kamusta kayo? Ako si Erica. Hi everybody! I'm Erica. Welcome to FilipinoPod101.com's Filipino sa Tatlong Minuto, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Filipino. In the last lesson, we learned how to be grateful to people by saying salamat. In this lesson, we'll learn some of the most common greetings used in the Philippines. Handa na ba kayo? Are you ready? Then let's start. First, we'll learn the greetings we use when meeting people. Kamusta? Kamusta? Do you remember this from the first lesson? Kamusta literally means, how are you? But it is used as hi or hello. Musta is a shortened version of kamusta, which you can use when greeting friends. Musta. For formal situations, we use kamusta po. Kamusta po. Now, here are sometimes specific greetings used when meeting people. Magandang araw. Magandang araw. Literally, magandang araw means good day. To be more specific about which time in the day we greet someone, we use magandang umaga, magandang tanghali, and magandang hapon, meaning good morning, good noon, and good afternoon respectively. Magandang umaga. Magandang tanghali. Magandang hapon. During the evening, there is only one greeting and that is magandang gabi. Magandang gabi. Maganda means beautiful or good. The connector NG is added to connect maganda and gabi. In formal situations, you just need to add po to the Filipino greetings I've already mentioned. Magandang araw po, magandang umaga po, magandang tanghali po, magandang hapon po, magandang gabi po. Are you ready for more? Next are some greetings we use when leaving. To say goodbye in Filipino, we say paalam. Paalam. We also have, sige, mauna na ako. Literally, all right, I'll go ahead. And it's a more casual way of saying goodbye. Sige, mauna na ako. Finally, we have hanggang sa muli, meaning see you again. Hanggang sa muli. Again, to make these formal, we just need to add po. Paalam po. Sige, mauna na po ako. Hanggang sa muli po. Now you can greet people in many different ways in Filipino. Let's review them all again. Here are the greetings we use when meeting people. Kamusta? Magandang araw. Magandang umaga. Magandang tanghali. Magandang hapon. Magandang gabi. When leaving, we have paalam. Sige, mauna na ako. Hanggang sa muli. For greeting people who are older than you, just add po. It's easy, isn't it? Now it's time for Erica's tips. Another famous greeting you might hear in the Philippines is Mabuhay. This literally means live, but it's used to mean welcome. It is used in formal situations like when welcoming an audience during events, or when welcoming people into the country, but not necessarily when welcoming guests to your home. During the next lesson, we'll learn the meaning of the phrase, Nagsasalita ka ba ng Ingles? Do you already know it? I'll be waiting to talk about it with you in our next Filipino sa Tatlong Minuto lesson. Hanggang sa muli! Kamusta kayo? Ako si Erica. Hi everybody, I'm Erica. Welcome to FilipinoPod101.com's Filipino sa Tatlong Minuto, the fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Filipino. In the last lesson, we learned the most common greetings in Filipino. Do you remember them? In this lesson, we're going to learn a very useful phrase. Do you speak English? This phrase can be a lifesaver. The majority of Filipino people understand English. But if you ask in Filipino, you can be sure that everyone will understand what you're saying, even if their answer is no. Here's the informal way to ask it. Nagsasalita ka ba ng Ingles? Nagsasalita ka ba ng Ingles? Let's break down the sentence. In Filipino, the verb can come before the subject. Nagsasalita means speaking, followed by ka, which means you. Next, there is ba, which is the question marking particle. After it comes nang, which acts as an object marking particle, marking Ingles, which, as you might have guessed, is English. Another common way to ask if someone can speak English is, marunong ka bang mag-Ingles? Literally, this means, can you do English? Marunong ka bang mag-Ingles? Now we're going to make these sentences formal. Filipinos follow the Spanish custom of changing a singular pronoun to plural in order to show respect in formal situations, so we change ka to kayo and then move it after ba. We also need to add po as a sign of respect. Everything else stays the same. Nagsasalita po ba kayo ng Ingles? Marunong po ba kayong mag-Ingles? Nagsasalita po ba kayo ng Ingles? Marunong po ba kayong mag-Ingles? If you want to be even more formal, you can add mawalang galang lang po before the sentence. It means, excuse me, mawalang galang lang po. Nagsasalita po ba kayo ng Ingles? Excuse me, do you speak English? Mawalang galang lang po. Marunong po ba kayong mag-Ingles? Here are some common responses you might hear. Oo. Yes. Oo. Konti. A little. Konti. Hindi. No. Hindi. Now it's time for Erica's tips. For those of you who are not only English speakers, you can use this question with any language you need. Just substitute Ingles with Espanol for Spanish, Hapon for Japanese, Italiano for Italian, Aleman for German, and so on. Now you know how to ask if people speak English or even your native language. But I hope this doesn't stop you from learning Filipino. We'll be learning more ways to say excuse me and I'm sorry in our next Filipino sa Tatlong Minuto lesson. Hanggang sa muli! Kamusta kayo? Ako si Erica. Hi everybody, I'm Erica. Welcome to FilipinoPod101.com's Filipino sa Tatlong Minuto. The fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Filipino. In the last lesson, we learned the phrase, mawalang galang lang po. Nagsasalita po ba kayo ng English? Excuse me, do you speak English? We mentioned the phrase, mawalang galang lang po, which means, excuse me, in formal Filipino. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to use this and other words when apologizing in Filipino. We can use mawalang galang lang po when we need to stop someone to ask a question. It literally means just to be rude, but is used to mean excuse me. For example, mawalang galang lang po, nasaan po ang palengke? Excuse me, where is the market? Mawalang galang lang po, nasaan po ang palengke? There is another phrase we use to mean excuse me, and that is paumanhin po. However, paumanhin po is used when you have bothered someone and could also mean I'm sorry. Paumanhin po. We use mawalang galang lang po and paumanhin po exclusively for formal situations. For informal situations, Filipinos usually just say, excuse me. But if there is something you really want to apologize for, it might be better to use a different phrase. That phrase is, patawarin mo ako. It means, please forgive me. And is used in informal situations. Patawarin mo ako. In formal situations, we say, patawarin niyo po ako. Patawarin niyo po ako. Here we added po and turned the second person pronoun into plural. Another common phrase Filipinos use for apologizing is, pasensya na po kayo. Pasensya na po kayo. This phrase is usually heard from shopkeepers when apologizing to customers. It can be translated as, please be patient with us. Now it's time for Erica's tips. In the Philippines, it is normal to simply say, excuse me, or I'm sorry, since English is commonly used in conversation. You could also add po to these phrases to make them sound a bit more formal and sincere. Excuse me po, or excuse po, I'm sorry po, or sorry po. Are you able to count in Filipino? In the next lesson, we will learn the numbers in Filipino from 1 to 19. I'll be waiting for you in our next Filipino sa Tatlong Minuto lesson. Hanggang sa muli!
Most people who learn a foreign language learn it so that they can one day have real-life conversations with native speakers. When you start out learning and crack open your first textbook or listen to your first podcast, having a real conversation can feel like a fantasy. When everything about a language feels new, it can be overwhelming. But this couldn't be further from the truth. While it does take a significant amount of time and effort to become fluent, having a conversation might not be as far off as you think. In this video, we'll look at three ways you can boost your conversational skills and start talking to native speakers. Number one, find native speakers and practice with them. It's unlikely you live near a big group of native speakers to practice with. If you happen to be in a major or international city, your chances may be better. Check and see if your city has a general language exchange. Chances are there could be a native speaker there who is also trying to learn another language. practicing in person with a native speaker is probably the most interesting option for honing your speaking skills. But if you can't find anyone where you live, the next best option is to look online. Luckily for language learners, the past 10 years or so have seen an explosion in online language exchange sites. On these websites, you can search for someone who is a native speaker of your target language and is also learning your native language. The idea behind a language exchange is that you communicate with them via video or text chat, and half of the time, they help you practice your target language. And for the other half, you help them practice theirs. Practicing via an online language exchange is a highly effective way to practice your conversational skills. Number two, work on pronunciation. Pronunciation is often an overlooked skill when it comes to learning a foreign language. Most people think of a good foreign accent as a luxury rather than a necessity. But what most people don't talk about is how having a good accent boosts your listening and comprehension skills. If you can hear a sound from a foreign language and know how to make it yourself, then you're more likely to understand native speakers when they talk at normal speed, and you're also more likely to remember any new words or phrases you come across. Having a good accent means that the language no longer sounds foreign. Instead, it sounds familiar, maybe even natural. So, how do you go about perfecting your accent? The best way is to break down the language into its individual sounds. Make note of any sounds that are the same or similar to your native language, and of those that are different. Of the sounds that are different, spend your time practicing the ones that you find the hardest to say correctly. After you're comfortable with the individual sounds, you can start linking together words and phrases. This is where accent practice starts to get really fun and interesting. Get your hands on some native speaker audio from a TV show, song, or podcast. Play the audio back and listen closely a few times. Take note of how words blend together in speech. Then, do your best to imitate what you hear, trying to match the speaker's emphasis and intonation. Our language learning program's playback feature is perfect for this. Record yourself and compare it to the original recording. Rinse and repeat until you're comfortable with the audio selection, and then move on to something more difficult. This is how you can break through the accent barrier and really start to make the language your own. Number three, learn phrases, not just individual words. Learning grammar and individual words is great, but it's not the only approach you should take if you want to speak fluently. In addition to your regular grammar and vocabulary, try learning whole phrases, even if you aren't totally sure how they work grammatically. Learn phrases that are specific to your needs. It's a good idea to learn phrases that are grouped around a certain setting or subject, such as simple greetings or introductions, questions for getting to know someone, or traveling comfortably. You can even learn filler phrases, which you can use so that you have something to say when, well, you don't know what to say. Learning phrases like this will help you become conversational faster. You may not understand what you're saying literally, but as long as you know the general meaning behind the phrase and know when to use it, you'll be able to talk like a native. Eventually, your knowledge of grammar and vocabulary should catch up with the phrases you know. Learning a new language should feel like an adventure. There will be plateaus and periods in your learning where it feels like you're hitting a wall, but being able to speak with native speakers and have real conversations will help you combat language fatigue. After all, talking to someone face-to-face in a foreign language is one of the main reasons we start learning in the first place. And for even more ways to gain conversation skills, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye!
In this video, you'll learn 20 of the most common words and phrases in Filipino. Hi everybody, my name is Say. Welcome to the 800 Core Filipino Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Filipino. But there's a twist. With each new lesson in this series, we'll include the previous lessons at the end. So after you've learned the new words and phrases, stick around and review what you've learned in previous lessons. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get a full list right now at FilipinoPod101.com. Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard deck, and finally, master Filipino. Okay, let's get started. First is saging, banana, saging, saging, banana. Hinahain ang pichi-pichi sa dahon ng saging. Pichi-pichi is served on a banana leaf. Hinahain ang pichi-pichi sa dahon ng saging. Mansanas. Apple. Mansanas. Mansanas. Apple. Ikuha mo ako ng mansanas. Get me some apples. Ikuha mo ako ng mansanas. Ubas. Grape. Ubas. Ubas. Grape. Maraming ubas sa mesa. There are many grapes on the table. Maraming ubas sa mesa. Pakwan. Watermelon. Pakwan. Pakwan. Watermelon. Pakibaba ang presyo ng mga pakwan. Please lower the price of the watermelons. Pakibaba ang presyo ng mga pakwan. Ibon. Bird. Ibon. Ibon. Bird. Naririnig mo ba ang mga ibon? Do you hear the birds? Naririnig mo ba ang mga ibon? Daga. Mouse. Daga. Daga. Mouse. Ang daga ay kumakain ng ubas. The mouse is eating a grape. Ang daga ay kumakain ng ubas. Araw. Sun. Araw. Araw. Sun. Ang araw ay isang bituin. The sun is a star. Ang araw ay isang bituin. Panahon. Weather. Panahon. Panahon. Weather. Ano ang lagay ng panahon sa Maynila? What's the weather like in Manila? Ano ang lagay ng panahon sa Maynila? Antas. Degree. Antas. Antas. Degree. Wala pang isang antas sa labas. It is barely 1 degree outside. Wala pang isang antas sa labas. Babae. Woman. Babae. Ba-ba-e. Woman. Ang babae ay lumalangoy sa pool. The woman swims in the pool. Ang babae ay lumalangoy sa pool. Lalaki. Man. Lalaki. La-la-ki. Man. Binuksan ng lalaki ang ilaw. The man turned on the light. Binuksan ng lalaki ang ilaw. Kasintahan na babae. Girlfriend. Kasintahan na babae. Kasintahan na babae. Girlfriend. Mayroon ka bang kasintahan? Do you have a girlfriend? Mayroon ka bang kasintahan? Kasintahan na lalaki. Boyfriend. Kasintahan na lalaki. Kasintahan na lalaki. Boyfriend. Sa kasintahan ko yan. It's my boyfriend's. Sa kasintahan ko yan. Tren. Train. Tren. Tren. Train. Anong oras ang huling tren? What time is the last train? Anong oras ang huling tren? Eroplano. Airplane. Eroplano. Eroplano. Airplane. Ang mga pasahero ay lumipad sakay ng eroplano. The passengers flew on the airplane. Ang mga pasahero ay lumipad sakay ng eroplano. Bus. 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 Pupunta ba ang bus na ito sa paliparan? Does this bus go to the airport? Pupunta ba ang bus na ito sa paliparan? Taxi. 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 Lima kami sa isang taxi. There were 5 of us in one taxi. Lima kami sa isang taxi. Espinaka. Spinach. Espinaka. Espinaka. Spinach. Mahilig akong kumain ng espinaka. I love to eat spinach. Mahilig akong kumain ng espinaka. Lumba lumba. Dolphin. Lumba lumba. Lumba lumba. Dolphin. Ang lumba lumba ay lumalangoy sa karagatan. The dolphin is swimming in the ocean. Ang lumba lumba ay lumalangoy sa karagatan. Pusit. Squid. Pusit. Pusit. Squid. Ang mga pusit ay lumalangoy malapit sa mga corales. The squid is swimming near the coral reef. Ang mga pusit ay lumalangoy malapit sa mga corales. Well done! In this lesson, you expanded your vocabulary and learned 20 new useful words. Click the link in the description and sign up for free at filipinopod101.com to get access to the full list of vocabulary you need for daily life conversations. You also get example sentences, costume plus card decks, and more learning resources. See you next time! Paalam!
Today we're going to talk about 4 techniques to help you stop translating in your head and instead start thinking in your target language. This will allow you to have conversations with ease, read smoothly, and better understand native speakers. These are four methods to help you think in a new language. Number one, surround yourself with your target language. This way, you'll be completely immersed in the language. Without realizing it, you'll learn pronunciation, sentence structures, grammar, and new vocabulary. Play music in the background while you're cooking, or have a radio station on while you study. Just use one of our endless podcasts available to you. These are easy to listen to in the background while doing other things. Number two, learn through observation. This is how we all learned our native languages as kids. Words will develop their own meanings that relate better to your target language, rather than meanings that are translated directly. Number three, speak out loud to yourself. Even if you're a little embarrassed, it forces you to listen to how you speak. It makes it much easier to spot simple grammar mistakes. Number four, practice daily. If you practice everything for only one day, you won't retain the information you learned. The brain can realistically only focus for about 30 minutes. So studying a little every day allows you to absorb better. Follow these steps and have patience. You'll soon be able to achieve your language learning goals. Just make sure to remember these four methods. Sign up for your free lifetime account. No credit card required, and you'll get the best free online resources. And start learning more every day.
Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Filipino ebook before it's gone.